I'm bad ass. And you're good ass. You're goody little two shoes. You're goody little two shoes. Goody little two shoes.
We interrupt your dull life to bring you something bewildering.
Remote control, big screen TV with stereo, football, baseball, NASCAR too, with picture and it's all in view. And if it comes on just a little too late, with the free ZRs you can get it on tape. He's a high-tech redneck.
Zone. I'm your high-tech redneck host, Justin T. Sutherland. Guess what? It's Christmas! So to celebrate the day of Christ's birth, I'm going to give you a useful gift. How to wipe your hard drive.
Disk formatting is the process of preparing a data storage device such as a hard disk drive, solid-state drive, floppy disk, or USB flash drive for initial use. In some cases, the formatting operation may also create one or more new file systems. The first part of the formatting process that performs basic preparation is often referred to as low-level formatting. Partitioning is the common term for the second part of the process, making the data storage device visible to an operating system. The third part of the process, usually termed high-level formatting, most often refers to the process of generating a new file system. In some operating systems, all or part of these three processes can be combined or repeated at different levels, and the term format is understood to mean an operation in which a new disk is fully prepared to store files. A reformat is not the same as a reimage. A reimage is where you use the disk that came with your computer, or an OS disk, to install or reset your system back to the way it was fresh from the factory. A reformat is clearing the disk completely with nothing on it. As a general rule, formatting a disk leaves most if not all existing data on the disk medium, some or most of which might be recoverable with special tools. Special tools can remove user data by a single overwrite of all files in free space. Think of it this way. When you put something on the computer or drive, whether it be document, song, video, program, or whatever, it gets put in an area of the disk and the computer knows that that area is that item. Formatting, or reformatting as I and several others call it, is where the computer then forgets that there is something there and puts things on top of it. To most of us, we will never see that thing again. But for hackers and the government, they have special tools and programs that will let them see what we've got buried in our drives. First, I'm going to show you how to perform a low-level reformatting. Low-level reformatting is just like I described, where the computer treats the drive like a new drive and simply buries the information that was once on it. Then I will show you how to do a high-level reformatting. This is where the computer overhauls the drive, puts a new file system on the drive and everything. The only difference between the low-level and the high-level is high-level does the same thing as low-level, but it is best used if your drive has errors or bad sectors. I'll explain more on that when we get to it. Then I will show you what is called as a wiping. It is where you completely, totally, wholly, utterly, and permanently get rid of all data on your drive, making it so not even the US government can recover the data from it. I find this useful when I'm selling an old computer so that whoever the computer goes to can't potentially get my private information. But there is a warning that I must issue.
Warning, reformatting a drive will erase all data from that drive. Justin Tyler Southerland is not responsible for lost data due to you being a dunderhead and not backing up the data you wish to keep. Justin Tyler Southerland is also not responsible for any hardware or software damage that may occur due to your error or a simple fluke. Consider yourself warned. Now take a breath, eat a cookie, and enjoy the rest of the show.
Now sit down, buckle up, and let's begin. This how-to is rated
Level 3. Difficulty rank, medium. Intended users, intermediates and above.
First off, I shall show you how to do a basic low-level format. I shall be demonstrating on my 16GB Gorilla Drive flash drive. First, go to My Computer, or on Windows 8, it's called My PC. Then find the drive you're wanting to format and right-click on it. Go up on the pop-up menu and normal-click the word Format. Another pop-up will appear. Make sure Quick Format is checked, and then click Start. A warning will pop up that states you're about to lose all data on your drive. If you have backed up your drive, then click OK. As you can see, it takes just a few shakes of a lamb's tail to format and boom, you're done. Click OK followed by Close and see? All data has been removed from the drive. Now to show you how to do a high-level format on the same drive. High-level formatting is most often used if your drive is experiencing errors or has a bad sector. First, go to My Computer, or on Windows 8, it's called My PC. Then find the drive you're wanting to format. And as you can see, I have a few items here. Example folder, Sandra Bullock, something I probably shouldn't have, a shameless plug for my book, and so on. So right-click on the drive. Go up on the pop-up menu and click the word Format. Another pop-up will appear. Unlike last time, make sure Quick Format is not checked, and then click Start. The warning will pop up, so just click OK. Now be advised, the formatting process takes a bit longer than the low level. I have found it to be roughly 1 minute per gigabyte, so I would recommend doing this at night or when you're away from the house so that it'll be done when you get back. Now it's time for the big rig, grand poobah of all data cleansers, the complete drive wipe. First, you need to go to www.diskwipe.org. The address is up on the screen right now. I guess it would help if I typed in the correct address, wouldn't it? Now scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Drive Wipe. You'll go to a new page, and you need to simply click on Download Disk Wipe. You'll be asked to save the file, so save it to a location you can easily get to and can remember. I'm saving it to my Downloads folder, which in most web browsers is the default choice. Once it's downloaded, all you have to do is go to where you downloaded it. And double-click the Disk Wipe program. In the side menu of the program, find the drive you want to wipe. For this example, I'm using a 16GB SD card that I use for my movie camera. The camera labeled it Kodak, so I just have to find it and select it. When you click, you'll see a bunch of information that isn't really needed right now. So just go up and click on Wipe. A pop-up will appear and ask what kind of file system you want to put on your drive. I already know my SD card uses FAT32, so I select that. Just so you know, FAT is used for small drives, roughly 2GB and under. FAT32 is used for drives that are roughly 2 gigabytes and over, and NTFS is used for things like external hard drives that are 100 gigabytes and over. Once you have selected the option for your drive, you will click on Next. You will then be treated to a list of options. All options will wipe your drive clean, but to different degrees. The top quick option will wipe your drive clean and will make it difficult to recover data, but not impossible. The bottom option will wipe your drive so clean, the US government won't even be able to extract the data. To save time, I'm going to select the quick option, then click Next. Now type in what it tells you to confirm that you are sure that you want to wipe the drive, then click Finish. One last time, it'll ask you if you are sure. So if you are, click OK. And now the process begins. There is a small warning I must inform you about. The quick option on this program took 5 hours and 20 minutes to wipe a 16GB SD card. Do the math, and that comes to 20 minutes per gigabyte. That means if I wanted to do the utmost wipe, which wipes it 35 times, it would take 700 minutes per gigabyte. Which means for my little 16GB SD card, the utmost would take roughly 8 days in real time. So this program is not for a speedy wipe, but it is the best that I have found. This one is strongly recommended to do while you are asleep at night. Also, if you happen to know of a program that wipes faster but still maintains this level of deletion, by all means, let me know. I would love to use a different program. I don't know if everyone will have this problem, but as for me, when it's done, the program will freeze and say it's not responding. If yours does this too, simply wait for a moment and let it unfreeze itself. Once it is done, click Close, and you're done. You now know how to wipe a drive on multiple levels. Well, Geeklings, Christmas is in just a few days, my birthday in 10, so I'm going to spend time with family.
Well, that does it for this episode, Geeklings. Our next episode in 2 weeks will be at the beginning of the new year. So until then, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We now return you to your normal broadcast. Thank you.
Redneck host Justin T. Sutherland. Guess what? It's Christmas!